Hey guys, what's going on? It's time for another video. In this video, we're going to watch another demo for my viewers. Today we have Liam Lele. He's a legendary Eagle Master. Great name, by the way. He wanted me to review his demo, so we are going to do that. Before we start, I want to say a couple of things. First of all, thank you all so much for watching. I really, really appreciate it. Thank you for liking, subscribing. Everything has been so nice. Suggestions are also welcome. I also want to thank that guy that said my videos are absolutely terrible. I'm sorry, dude, that I couldn't help you, but I really appreciate that comment as well. So if you're watching, thank you. And something as well that I wanted to say is some people have been asking if they can donate. Well, of course, I have a PayPal link in the description as well as a trade URL in the description. If you really want to trade some items or some money, that's very, very welcome. I will put everything towards my channel. So if you donate by PayPal, I will put this towards a new microphone or webcam. I'm not sure yet. Or maybe I will put this towards, yeah, it's going to be towards the channel. And if you donate items, I will put this towards a giveaway, or I will just keep them myself because some people don't want me to give them away, and I will mention your name in the next video. So that's my reward if you donate. So thank you all so much for that. I really appreciate it, and thank you for the demos as well. Keep them coming. I've been doing about 15 so far. It's a lot of work because remember, each match is about 45 minutes. I fast forward through them, but the writing, the answering questions, it takes about 45 minutes per video, and sometimes they crash. It's absolutely terrible. It's a lot of work, but I enjoy it so much, so keep them coming. I've been asking for the demos, and I've been getting the demos, so yeah, it's been tons of fun. So we are going to start with the demo. We are starting on Inferno Terrorist Site. And let's hope for a lot of rushes, because rushes are a lot to... They are fun to review. We have a little bit of lag, so let's hope that goes away. There we go. So we have 5 armor. Going for that almost legendary B rush. So, interesting situation here. We have 2 guys already super aggressive. 2 terrorists super aggressive. But they have a 3-man stack on B. This is going to be troublesome. And I'm actually going to make you a small bet now. The terrorists are going to lose. Why? This smoke is extremely aggressive and extremely good. And there is going to be a moment where you are going to rush through the smoke. And the CTs will be able to see you, but you won't be able to see them. Their pre-aim, their everything is so much easier and so much better for them that they are just going to destroy you. So often what I like to do is, when I see an aggressive smoke like this, I just tell everyone, go back. Wait, don't rush, do something, but don't rush through a smoke like this. It's just suicide. I often hear people say, don't be pussies, just run through a smoke, whatever, YOLO. But you're often going to lose, because a powerful smoke like this is just suicide. We will see what happens. So yeah, the CTs are just cleaning up. As you saw, you were just shooting in the middle of the map, or the middle of of the wall. You were not shooting everyone. It's just suicide, so don't do it. It's going to be really bad. Just try to fall back. Don't do it all the time. Of course, rushing through smokes can often be very strong. You might be the first one rushing through. You're just suiciding. But this time it was just a suicide. Don't do it, especially in pistol. Well, maybe in pistol that's actually the time to rush through a smoke. But that smoke was just too perfect. Fall back. Okay, next round. It's going to be laggy. There we go. It's going to be a force buy. So that's why I did want to check this part out. Often when I go second mid, and actually second mid is my favorite place to go. Sometimes I go there 15 rounds in a row. But what I usually like to do is I walk here. From this point I walk. Why? If there is a guy rushing dark here, or he's rushing the stairs, you can often hear him rushing. And you have so much information if you know he's over here or he's rushing apps over here. So try to walk here. And believe me, if you know there's a guy over here on dark, boiler, whatever you want to call it, it's so easy to kill him. He's going to wait. He will eventually come out or something. Or you throw a nade, you throw a smoke, a flash, whatever. But if you have knowledge of him being here, it's going to help you out so much. What I often like to do here as well is I walk, I hear them push. You can often hear them. And believe me, if you run towards this part of second mid, and then you walk, and they will, you know, get really close. There is a timing where you will hear them. So, you know, believe me, trust me in this. I did a lot of tests on this. So, if they are rushing towards dark, you will hear them 100%. And what I often like to do is I will wait in front of the entrance here. So what happens a lot is after like 45 seconds, they like to push out because they think it's clear. They will walk down the stairs. They will, you know, try to get control of second mid. And then it's just a free kill. And believe me, in Global or Supreme, whatever, even on Legendary Eagle, it's worth so much getting a free kill like this. So let's see what you do. You're just rushing through. And as you can see here, the guy was super aggressive. He rushed through apartments here. And, you know, maybe you could have heard him if you were a bit more silent. Oh my god, the demo is laggy. Interesting scenario here. We have a bot, which is unlucky. But your teammate is pushing through to short here. And what you really want to do here is now follow him. And your only goal here is to check the left side of mid. Because what often happens is the CT will try to kill him now, right? So if he kills him or not, it doesn't really matter. But you will follow him. And at this point, this CT should be your kill. It's almost a free kill, so to speak. So just follow him and pick up the free kill. I said it worked out. So that's great. You guys won that round. You didn't even lose anyone. So that's fantastic. They have a bot, which is kind of unlucky. But let's hope they return. It's going to be a pause now. So we're going to skip that round. But yeah, try to walk a bit more. I just see that you like to run a lot. And sometimes it's just better to walk. Okay, let's speed it up. It's still an ego against a gun round, but it's not. We can still learn a lot from these kind of rounds. So you're pushing mid. You're kind of doing that alone. That's quite risky. Why? I can quickly show you this. Why? What if the guy, the CT, just pushes out here, shoots you in the face, grabs up the AK? Yeah, that's just terrible news. So don't do that. Maybe wait for your teammate a little bit or smoke the right side of mid. You're not even walking. You're making sound. This way of checking the left and right is also not perfect. Because I will show you. If you keep on doing this, I will show you how to do this better in my opinion. Now we have the back step from mid, from A. This is kind of interesting as well. Do you really need to rush here? You spotted free on B. Here, maybe they are spotted by the guys that are pushing through banana, but there is a chance that there will be Jesus Christ. The CSGO demo thing wants to be buggy, so there is a chance that there is going to be a guy over here, right? So why not walk this tiny bit so the guy over here can't hear you? And why not do that, right? There is absolutely no reason not to do this. The only reason I can think of is you guys know that everyone is on B. And you know, you want to get there as quick as possible to clean up the frags. But there's actually a CT on A, so you couldn't have known that. That spray control is decent. You're moving to left and right a bit, so you're harder to hit. But you just have to remember that it's also your spray control. Your bullets will, you know, be further apart from each other. So just keep that in mind. But often it's worth it to move to left and right when you're shooting like this. Let's speed it up again. CTs are buying. We have an AWP, a scout, and free enforce. We have actually a free SMGs, a shotgun, and a AK. Interesting buying. Don't copy this kind of stuff. Don't try. Like, after round 3, it's almost never worth it to get an SMG. Maybe it's worth it when you're low on money, you just won the round before and you know they are on eco, then it's worth it, then it's totally fine. But often it's terrible news. It's a 2-on-3. Interesting situation. Okay, you're shooting your teammate here. Really, one thing so important, check your radar. Check it like what I often do. I'm not even sure because I really have to think about this. But check your radar like every 10 seconds. This way you know where your teammates are. You know where the CT is all holding up. So let's say your teammates, this is especially for matchmaking, not for clans or anything, but let's say your teammates are not really calling, right? And what I often do is I go second mid, I wait somewhere in second mid. I often check my radar because sometimes I see, oh, there is three guys on B. So this should mean that, this means that there are only two on A, and maybe there's even a third on a B or a fourth on B. So there's going to be only one on A. It gives away a lot of information. Maybe this means they are eco and they are stacking, or they have a troll or whatever. But it gives me some information that, okay, if I know there is only two on A, this usually means that there is one in apps and maybe one on long. So maybe short is free, or maybe apps is free. There's always going to be a position free, right? Because they cannot hold everything with only two people. They need at least three for that. So keep that in mind. And it gives you a lot of opportunities if you get information like this. So more minimap watching, because you kind of killed your teammate. So one on three. You can still win this. Don't give up. I want to see what the CT said. You give away your position now. Nice aiming. And there we go. They were low HP, so you are cleaning up. This is interesting. I'm not sure how you know that the CT is not on A. What if he's on A? You have plenty of time. You have 1 minute. Why risk it to go for a rush? Maybe it's called. That's possible, of course. Good plant. Getting that plane down as fast as possible is important, of course. But you could have walked a bit here. And this is extremely risky. What if the guy went... he rushed for mid. Rushed for short. You would have been dead. Still making sound. You really want to make less and less sound. Interesting pre-aim. So... what if the guy comes through apps? What if he... it's actually possible, right? What if he pushed... mid here and went for apps. There's going to be an opportunity for him to come out of apps. So oh, you actually hear him in second in short. That's unlucky for him, not for you. You hear the jumps, you hear the defuse, you check right away. Oh my god, that's sloppy. Why is that sloppy? There is a smoke, of course, but he just defused, right? He didn't defuse for 2-3 seconds. And, this is sloppy because it was a great plant. When something like this happens and there is a better smoke, this is not even a good smoke, right? Wait like a second before you fire, because when you fire, you give away your position and you're actually giving away your upper hand. You give away your favorable position. So when there is a smoke down like this, wait a second, wait maybe 1.5 seconds, maybe something like this. Then when you don't see him, then you know he's not faking, and then try to start firing through the smoke, right? But this was just sloppy, and you kind of gave away the round. After you done so well, you first shoot your teammate, then you kill two, but then you have like perfect position, but you kind of give it away. And there are so many aspects in this round. So you had a bit of map awareness where you lacked. Then you did great on the... killing the two guys, the guy on banana, although the guy on banana could have shot you. And then you did great on map awareness because you knew the last guy was not on A. Maybe it's magic, maybe, I don't know, but maybe what was called. But then you kind of fucked up by making a bit too much noise and taking too long to get into apps. And then, yeah, whatever happened then, well, we already know. Next round, you're going for the Molly. So, interesting Molly. Of course, car, they can't really get to car. But this is a very expensive investment just to get a Molly at a car. So, okay, you're being aggressive. So, it actually pays off, kind of. But what's your plan here with the Molly? So, you guys are falling back now. Interesting. So, wait. You use a Molly. I'm not sure if there was a terrorist smoke or a CT smoke, but there is a smoke. So someone invested a smoke and then you try to fall back. That's an expensive investment for absolutely nothing. You didn't create anything with that. Nothing. So, okay, it's a 4 on 5 because they have a bot. This is interesting. There's one guy checking mid and another guy jumping in front of him. That's the legendary eagle play tactic. Don't ask me how that works. I'm not a legendary eagle. The smoke for your teammate, which is nice. You really want to be near your teammate here. Get a bit closer to cover him better. You're making a ton of sound. We have this... we have a terrorist extremely deep and you're making sound. This can be good or this can be bad, right? You've been making a lot of sound during the round so far, so I think you're not really thinking too much about that. But what if there is a CT over here, right? What if there is a CT that pushed into second mid? You guys are not covering second mid at all. What if he went through apps and he pushed second mid and he's behind you? You know, you're giving away too much information when it's not necessary. Why you didn't walk this? Right? Why you didn't walk this tiny bit on mid? Maybe you want, you know, we can also go way deeper. Maybe you wanted to lure out this guy on short. You know, you wanted him to run through a smoke so your friend can pick him up. I'm not sure, but I doubt you were thinking that. So this is nice cover. You wanted to cover a bit more here. He was out in mid. So, you know, what if the CT decided to peek, right? And you were aiming at this. You cannot help your friend at this point. And you might make the decision to go back, you know, to check long here. And then the CT would be firing and killing your teammate. And he would automatically be firing on you because you just moved back. I hope you guys understand what I'm trying to say here. But if you cover for a teammate, don't peek. It's not necessary. It's not helping you at all. If he's out in the open, you better always, you know, make sure you cover him at any moment, all the time. There is no need to move from left to right. Because now you're in a world of trouble. Now you're pushing together towards long. Interesting. What if the city tries to push to short? There's absolutely nothing covering you and it would just be a freak double kill. And especially because you made so much noise, this CT should know there was something on mid. So risky, very risky. The CT on CT spawn just managed to get away. So now you decide to run, giving away information yet again. So what if the CT decided to move over here, right? He would have hurt you and you would have been in a world of trouble because you're not really checking that at all. So I think that's sloppy. So what if there was a CT over here? He would have killed you and he would have killed your teammate most likely because your teammate is making noise as well. So try to walk this tiny bit. And it was also extremely risky what you were doing, this kind of push with a bomb. B was clear, so it would have been better to give the bomb on B because what if you guys got killed on A? It would have been you guys would have been in a world of trouble. So yeah, I'm actually wondering, and I'm kind of, do you even see the CT? Yeah, you don't even see him. He's making noise, so you should have heard him. You didn't even see him. You get the kill in the end, but you're sloppy. You're sloppy, and I want you to work on that, your sloppiness. Your aim is fine, your spray is fine, your you know, your battling when there are even odds is totally fine. You're going for the molly yet again. Keep it in mind as well. When you throw a molly every round, the CTs are not going to be there. And they might actually use this against you. For example, having this perfect rush. He's actually going to get a double kill, isn't he? He is. So what did this money accomplish? Nothing. It's a waste of money and it is actually working against you. So when you use a nade, basically every nade you use should have some thinking about it. What I often hear is, this is on Dust2, so imagine Dust2, and I'm a terrorist and I push towards B. So right from when I spawned, I push towards B, I hear a flash. And I'm like, dude, that's such a waste of a flash because I cannot even be there yet. I can't be there. That flash is never going to flash anyone ever in the world. In a million years, it won't flash anyone because there is, it's not possible for any terrorist to be there yet, right? So think about your flashes. Just don't throw flashes every round. You know, some people like to smoke it every round. Why do that? Like, I get it, you want to do an anti-rush, but if you have like an idea about money, right, economy, if they have an ego, why the hell are you smoking it for? I mean, yeah, if they are rushing every round, sure, go throw that smoke every round, then it's fine. But then you at least thought about it, right? Now you're not thinking about it, I feel. And I really hope you're never throwing that molly again in this map, in this match. Throw it throw it's lagging. I hate this so much. Throw it in the next match, fine, but don't throw it in this one anymore. Okay, there we go. Round number 8. Pushing mid, making a lot of sound. Now you're walking, which I like to see. But then your teammate decides to make a ton of noise. At this point, you must know, okay, the CTs could have heard me. So I must be scared. They might be really close. Okay, you guys are pushing. Interesting. So what is the scenario? We have 2 on B, 1 in apps. Super aggressive. And now you guys are just decided to push mid. This is typical matchmaking, right? We are just pushing mid. The rest of the team, we don't care about them. What I really want is, guys, come on, get at least a third here. Then it would be more viable. Get him to cover you from the right. There is a big possibility that the CT pushes through smoke. That's what smokes are for, right? I mean, they cover me. So why SST? I wouldn't go through them. I don't get that. Okay, yet again, you are pushing mid. So look at this. You're both watching the same. You're watching the same in the same direction. So what if SST pushes through the smoke? It's super risky for him, but in this moment it will actually pay off because there's no one watching mid. Not even the guys that are near mid are watching you or covering you. So this is extremely risky. Just don't do it. You're even taking your time. You're taking your sweetest time. You're not having cover from behind. Still making sound right now. It's a miracle that the CT didn't kill you here. I see what you guys are doing. You went for a fast push on A, right? But this is fine pushing through it like this, making a ton of sound when you're 5 men or 4 men or whatever, but risky, all over the... It just screams riskiness. It was still with 4, I know, but it's risky. Okay, next round. I'm gonna skip a couple because we have been doing, like, we have only missed 1 so far. Okay, this is a buy round from the CT. It's half a buy round. So we will see. It's interesting, he's buying a deagle. Armor helmet. You don't usually need a helmet against a terrorist. Full utility. Okay. Great. Oh my god. The molly. You really want that control? That molly didn't even do anything. It didn't even explode. So again, a waste of a molly. And the CTs are just killing up kills like this. Like, ask yourself, what are you trying to achieve with this? I will not talk too much about it. We already know, but you know, mollies can be so powerful. A small situation, you guys pushing on B. You know there's a CT on dark. Throw that molly then, you know. Then it has actual value. Okay, another small scenario. You guys are pushing short. You know there's a guy on pit. Get that molly, you know, near the fountain over here. So he can't kill you guys from there. It makes everything so much easier, and then the investment is already, then the investment is actually worth it. Fuck the, okay, there we go, we got rid of the lag. When I'm pausing on pausing like this, it's just me trying to get rid of the lag. The lag is caused, by the way, by CSGO. I cannot really fix that myself, I think, at least I think. Okay, the smoke goes down, people making noise. You guys making so much noise, it's unbelievable. Okay, the push. Yet again, one guy staying behind, right? Is that? Yeah, that's one guy staying behind. You're going for the push. You could have waited a tiny bit for this guy to come by. More radar. Please watch your radar a bit more. Yeah, so I will maybe make a video about this. You know, I'm thinking about making some guides, and because like this push is so weak because of that. This guy is just staying in mid. He was kind of covering your ass, which I don't agree with to begin with. You really have to get the bomb down. And this looks weak, right? If you talk about it, there's one guy in banana. There's one guy in mid. There's two guys pushing A while they had four guys alive. It sounds wrong in my opinion. And if it sounds wrong, it's usually bad. Okay, round 13. We're gonna skip another one. So more radar watching. If I see this molly again, I'm gonna be angry. Okay, you heard him. This is perfect. You walked. This is a perfect example. You walked. You heard him. You reacted right away. So this gives you so much information. Okay, but now, what if I just heard that, I would think that he is in dark. Yeah, I can. You guys can say like, yeah, of course you can see him through the wall. You know he's going to be in dark, but it's kind of obvious, right? Okay, that noise, I don't get it. You're making noise again. Don't make that noise. You're giving away position to this guy. Don't do that. It's not necessary. This is a miracle. Okay, so this guy heard you. He knows you're there. He knows you about anywhere near second mid, right? But he's still going for the push. Interesting. That was unlucky. I almost shot him there. But I don't get the thinking. You heard the guy being aggressive in apps, and then you decide to push. Interesting. I don't really get that. There was already a molly. There was already a nade thrown there. So maybe wait a bit. Take it slow. And same goes for the CT. He heard you. He must have heard you. Why the hell would he be pushing? He should have known. Maybe because what often happens is when I hear someone like this, I say someone pushed boiler. Someone pushed dark, someone pushed apps, whatever. What often happens is I'm waiting here, my teammate is waiting over here, and when you walk down from stairs like this, first of all, this guy is going to kill him, and I will just peek and then kill you. It's suicide. But you had an advantage and you're basically giving it away by making noise. So let's see. Your economy seems to be decent. You're going for a armor helmet AK, which is fine in this round. Your teammates have plenty of money for utility. Let's see if you walk yet again. So now you decide to run. That was maybe just a fluke. Super aggressive. There is yet again a point where you can walk, right? I'm gonna show you what I'm talking about, because I'm kind of getting there is so much to explain. So I will show you. But after the round, you know it's too easy for the CT. It's just way too easy to for the CT to kill you with this AWP here, because you're making so much noise. Okay, so in your demo, I really felt you made too much sound. You were always running. Of course, you walked a couple of times. But I think if you increase your walking a bit more and make less sound in crucial situations, you will increase your skills so much. And, making too much sound is extremely bad. Why? Your opponents are going to know where you are. They are going to make different situations. So can you imagine if you're hacking and you can see everyone through the wall, you're going to make different situations, right? Because you know where everyone is. You are not, if there is five men pushing mid, you're not going to just go there, right? Because you're going to get shot in the face. So as same goes for sound. And basically sound is like wall hacking in a way, right? If you hear someone, you know where he is without really seeing him. So you must use the skill to your advantage. But also, if you are making sound and your opponent is making sound, he is basically looking through the wall and he sees you without you seeing him. So please make less sound. So I will show you a couple of things. First of all, my usual thing when I play on terrorist is I go second mid, and then it's around this point I start walking. I don't do the jump, but I start walking. Why? If they rush stairs, I can hear them. If they rush apps and go for dark here, I can hear them. And I usually walk to this. And if I heard nothing, I usually wait here a little bit, you know, patient. And when I see nothing and my teammates pushed up a bit as well, and it's fine for me to push, then I go in. A usual cue I also have is someone gets on, hey, he jumps into the apartments here, and then I push together with him so we can, you know, clear everything together. He usually checks dark, I check the stairs for him so he's fine, and then we can, you know, push together. This way it's much better for everyone. I didn't see that too much in your demo as well. So yeah, what you really want to do is more walking, and I will show you this in mid. Is okay, you are, you know, you were super aggressive here. Maybe someone can hear you. Okay, whatever, you know, you can't be silent all the time. But okay, I'm jumping again. I'm so sorry for that. But okay, why not just walk here? What's really the difference? So okay, let's count, right? So 1, 2, okay, like it's like 2 something, and now you're walking. So 1, 2, 3, so it's like double, right? It's something double. Is it really such a big difference, such a game changer if you be there a bit slower? But one thing I want to say is there are also people that walk too much. So let's say you are, it's a 3-on-3 and you guys want to push A, you're not sure where they are. But some people, you know, we are pushing, we are making sound, and they are still here walking, right? They are still walking and doing shit. No, they have to push with you as well. So don't walk too much. I just have to, you know, warn you in that. Don't walk all the time, but you know, walking, I think increase your walking is going to make you better. So okay, so you want to push short, mid here, so slow it down a bit. And this is also a thing where you kind of try to push mid. You were checking left and right, you were kind of doing something like this, you know, moving back and forth. Why not do this? This is a lot more safe, right? Get cover through the wall. If he decides to push here, you know, he must get into this really aggressive position, and then he might be able to see you, right? But then, you know, you go for that, you go for the mid, and you kind of can't control here. You're running, this is fine, this is right. But now, why not take a break, right? What if he's close, or he's rotating from B to A something? Then you can hear him, right? And then walk, check everything, and now maybe you have again a nice cue to run. Because if you just can ask yourself, if I run here and I have some teammates on banana, is there really a difference between me walking and running? Not really, right? So I'm gonna rush, I'm gonna check this. Is there like, it's not even normal for a CT to be here when you are rushing. But is there such a difference, really, if you're just going to check this by running or by walking? No, I don't really think there is such a difference. And at this point, I really think if you're running here, you're helping your teammates much more that are pushing banana, right? So just keep it in mind. Now I will have a small example when you are a CT and you want to rotate. And let's say the guy on long is killed, right? The guy on Arch, you're running, and now you want to walk. You don't know what's up, you have no information where they are for sure. Then, you know, you check every weird angle, you do something like this. This is risky. Then you move out, something like this. You walk, and this is totally fine. But then maybe your teammate says, okay, there's 3 left, right? 3 on A, or they are 3 on site, or there is 2 in pit and 1 on site, something like this. Then it's fine to run. Then you're gonna run. You don't have to check mid, you don't really have to check apps. And then at this point, you wanna walk again, because the guys from pit can hear you, the guy on site can hear you. It's like this, it's fine for them to hear you from time to time, but it's not fine that, I think it's really bad if you decide to, okay, now I'm gonna run. So the guys from pit can hear you, the guys from side can hear you, and they will be like, okay, there's someone short, close, right? And they're gonna be like this and kill you. You're giving your upper hand away. Because if you don't make sound, and you still want to push forever, I'm not sure why, but if there's a reason to push and there are plenty, you know, you can do something like this, and you can check pit in a really good way without being in so much trouble that this guy that is on site is going to, you know, because he really doesn't, he is not completely sure, and he has things to cover that he will come out right and kill you that way. No, there's a much bigger, smaller chance, I mean, that he actually will come out. So walk. And if you really think, okay, I'm in so much trouble now because I didn't see the guys in pit, but I want to get on site, kill that guy, then it's fine. Go for that rush. You know, go and kill him, then it's fine. Is it fine the other way as well? Let's check. I'm not completely sure. So let's say you don't want to kill the guy on site. You want to kill the guy on pit, but you are scared that this guy is going to kill you. Maybe then it's fine to do something like this, super aggressive, but your aim was decent, so it should be fine, right? Make calculated risks. They should be calculated, they should be in your favor, and I often think you didn't think too much about this. So this is what all I wanted to show you. Let's continue with the game. Okay, so the last round, or we are going to the pistol. Well, this looks so fucking desperate. Okay, I'm going to the pistol of CT. Let's go. Not a bad, you know, your aim is fine. So, but if you have to really work on your decision making here, especially sound, I feel. If you do this, I see a Supreme in the making within no time, believe me. If you're from Europe, by the way, I wouldn't mind playing with you, you know, to give you, to see, to maybe give you some, you might even, it would maybe work an in-game leader, you know, an in-game leader that tells you a bit more about what you have to do, might even help you a lot here. But thinking more about your actions is incredible. Okay, but we should be looking at this CT pistol here. There's not much to see. You're just getting cover. They are pushing. You're taking it slow. You're now getting cover from the smoke, which is nice. What can you really do here? Maybe wait for your teammates. Why not, right? This is risky. This was nice, trying to get a kill through the smoke. It's lucky for him. It's lucky for him that he gets the plan down. What I would have liked more, if I were your coach or something, get the fuck back, try to get cover. You know, there is a point now. Now it's like an even fight, right? It's kind of an even fight. It's 2-on-2. You guys can both see each other. I actually even think the terrorists have the upper hand because this guy is totally in the open and shooting you guys without being shot himself. But go back. The bomb is in such an awkward position that you guys can get into much more defensive positions, and they, you know, make the terrorist guess. They have to get a bomb down. They are in a world of trouble, so, you know. Okay, so you went back now. You're still super aggressive. You know, you're not making the terrorist guess at all. There's never any guessing. So I don't care what happens after this. Let's see if you guys go for the force buy. Should be. We went for the force buy last round. And you know what? If force buy is always worth it, in my opinion. I mean, you can easily win against a terrorist team. And picking up an AK or something when you're doing a force buy, like there's always one guy buying an AK, right? Is so much value. And it's such a small investment as well. So you always go for the force buy. You're going for the rush here, which is fine in my opinion. I would fall back right now. Rotate to A, yeah, the bomb is on A. He's battling. Maybe you can get there in time to get some free exit kills. This is unlucky, the jumping here. Walk. Really. Again, a perfect example. You get the kill now, but you are such a like crazy guy. And now you go into a defensive position. You should know there's a death cam, of course. So he knows where you are, but this is still fine. It's quite lucky here that you didn't die. I would really go into nice defensive positions here. You got the upper hand, so why give it away? And you're listening, which is good. Okay, this round should be won. I want to finish it to see if we have awkward things. Okay, there we go. You know, a small thing. When your teammate doesn't have a gun and you have already have a gun and you see a better one, throw him the AK. Or throw, I mean, not throw him the AK. Throw him your gun, right? Give him your gun. Why not? It's helping out your team. You guys know where he is. Nice defensive positions. Well, I wanted to be positive here, but you didn't really set up a crossfire. So either your teammate goes a bit more to the left or you go a bit more defensive. So when he shoots you, then your teammate should be able to kill him, right? Something like this. It didn't really happen now. You're kind of making it into an like a one-on-one all the time. It is a 3-on-1, remember that. And you changed it into a 1-on-1. Small detail, but important. Set up crossfires. There's actually a ton of people that are very good with that. And it's so strong. You know, often people, when they have the upper hand, like a 2-on-1, they often change it into 2 1-on-1s, right? And not into a 2-on-1. He's going for the smoke. This stops a rush for sure, but remember not to throw it every round because they don't seem the rushing types all the time. I'm okay, I've seen enough in this round, so just remember the smoke. Honestly, the terrorists don't look that strong either. Okay, cleaning up some kills. This is so risky. That was so risky. Jesus Christ. I know you were trying to get the bomb right away. When you go for the deagle like this, slow down a little bit with your firing. A deagle is usually very inaccurate. Although the first bullet is super accurate, usually, not always. But if you're firing like this in this speed, it's so luck-based that, you know, it's not worth it really. Slow it down a bit. Just stand still, wait like half a second and then fire, right? You were shooting too fast for a deagle. You know, you can often just go into a map, an empty map, train it. Shoot against the wall and see how fast you can shoot for the deagle to be accurate. Next round, let's speed it up. Ah. Aggressive yet again, MP90. P90, I mean. That smoke yet again. You're making a ton of sound again in SSCT as well. And believe me, as high. You know, you will get to a point, to a skill level point, where you will be punished for all of this. And you will think, what the fuck, they're hacking. But you're giving away so much information. Yet again, this guy was in underground, and you were making a ton of sound rushing from B. They will know. They will call it to each other. They will know. So they can now wait in a place for you to come. There's no need for them to push, right? They will still push, but there is no need. And now it's... You guys are changing into 2-on-3. It's a miracle that this... I don't get it. Why this guy doesn't really know that you are pushing here. But... wow, you can actually see each other. Yeah, okay, interesting. Not sure what happened there. But less sound. Less sound at critical moments. Okay, your teammate is super aggressive. You decide to go back. Don't do that. That's nice. Okay, next round. This should be won. I'm gonna skip a couple. Because I'm scared this is going to be a 14-16 game. You guys have the upper hand. Let's hope they go for an actual rush. No, they don't go for that again. Standing ready to cover your teammate. I love this. Especially when I go AWP and he's standing ready with a flash. Well, a molly is just as fine. It's just more expensive. Okay, flash. Rotating quickly. Are you rotating too quick here? Not sure. You guys already lost one. So I'm actually analyzing the scenario. Maybe it's fine, right? An AWP on B can hold himself very, very well. But yet again, you're making too much sound too early in critical positions. It was not necessary to run this part. Never. It wasn't. So don't do it. Liam Lele, your aim is great. You're like... you usually win all your battles against players, but if you would be more like, if you would be playing Counter-Strike more, what I'm trying to say is, if you listen more, if you walk more, if you are more technical, you're gonna get so much more done. You know, I have to say something. So I'm like saying so much negative shit that I kind of get scared. Oh my god, I will like be angry at me or something, but I'm not gonna hold back. Not anymore. That's the old me. I'm not gonna hold back. So you know, don't take it personal. Oh, you guys saw the guy again. You're rushing like a madman. There's no, you are an ego, so it's more acceptable for me, but slow it a bit down. It was nice, you know. You know, you could have walked towards here and then go for the push. That's fine, but you were just running non-stop. This is nice, getting those backstabs. Your teammate not covering you at all. There was a molly, of course. It was hard for you to cover it, but he didn't do a good job on it. Eco yet again. So twice an eco. You better not eco the next round. Okay, we have something of a push here. Getting into nice defensive position. This is still kind of aggressive. Because believe me, when the terrorists push, they will look at you. So you changed into an aim button, but that's fine. Don't shoot through the smoke here. You know, this was, you know, you have to really play more Counter-Strike. Be more... get more game sense. So you had this nice angle here. That was perfect. But then you decided to move out, totally lose any cover. So your entire body was, you know, in the your entire body was visible. So stay closer to the wall here. Stay closer to this wall. And then when they come like this, you have still have a chance to move back, because now you were just a target dummy, so to speak. Okay, let's speed it up. Let's fix the angle and speed it up. Okay, we have the buy round. Happy to see that. Going eco twice is not bad at all. Need to get rid of the lag. Guys, if you have any tips for this, I appreciate them. Man, maybe I have to pause a bit longer. It's totally shit. Shooting through smoke, that's always good. Although, I don't think you were very accurate on sound cue. So, the guy was actually more on the left and you were shooting more on the right. But, it was okay. It's not a big deal. And you just try to move out and get shot by an AWP. Okay. Is that smart? No, it's not smart. Is it unlucky? Maybe, but is it necessary? No. No, it's not necessary. There is no reason for you to peek there. Let them push. Let them get into an awkward situation, right? But I cannot say too much about this because I peek as well from time to time. And peeking is fine because you cannot just give away everything, right? Okay, going for the P90 rush. Yet again, you're running. Could have walked again. Walk a bit earlier. Now it's fine to rush because they know what's up. Smoke molly. Don't get that molly, but whatever. There's like no explanation. Like, we are smoking and mollying because we didn't see anyone, because we want to fall back, but there was so much pressure on us. I don't know. You guys still won, but yeah. That was a lucky. I was hoping for a terrorist to stay back and kill you because you were making too much sound. That's a nice molly. That's a nice molly. Like, that has some value behind it. Oh, now you go aggressive. You know, you had this nice angle. I know that it's nice to go aggressive, especially when they are flashing a lot of pressure. It was not necessary, but it's fine. It's a decision you make. You guys getting that fracking, and you won the map, so well done, well played. So what I want you to work on, your aim is fine, so don't work on that. Your battling between players, your peeking is kind of fine. Kind of fine, not all the time, but what you really want to work on. Liam Lele. And if I pronounce your name the wrong way, I'm so sorry. But is your noise and always running. You were always running, and I don't get that. Like, you know, you don't want to give your position away. And I understand that you don't think about that too much. You know, Counter-Strike is just a fun game. You're running around, you're shooting people, you get shot, you plant the bomb and it explodes. But it's so much more than that. There is so much thinking happening. Like, okay, but you know, like, what I'm trying to say is, like, your opponents have a brain of themselves as well, right? They are not target dummies. They actually have a brain. So if they hear you, they will act different to you when they don't hear you. You will never create free kills when you keep making sound everywhere, right? Because if my team goes for a 5-man push on B and I'm staying on A and like going for the backstep, but I'm making sound, they will never like try to rush to B. No, they will first, you know, wait and kill me. They will still wait for me to push. They will do something else. But if I'm actually silent in mid, and if I'm not making any noise, then they will maybe make the mistake of just pushing towards B because they think it's a 5-man B or something, right? You are never creating anything for yourself if you keep making the sound. So that's everything I really wanted to say, guys. I hope you enjoyed this part. I will now show you how you can send in your demo to me.